there. Welcome to Vidyarthi. My name is Anupriya. In this session, I'm going to introduce you some really very nice and smart phrases. Phrases are short in their structure, but it gives a big meaning when we use it with the sentence or in the sentence. Alright, so let's pick the first phrase. No wonder. What does it say? When you are really not surprised about anything which is going to happen or which is happening, then you use this phrase. I'll give an example. You really eat so less. No wonder you are so slim. Because you eat less amount of the food, so there is no wonder. I mean, I'm not surprised that why you are so slim, because you are really eating small portion of the meal. So that's why you are so slim. Another example. No wonder she is going to gain good marks in her exam, because she is studying very intensely. I am not very surprised, or I will not be very surprised that she is going to get good marks in exam. So when you are not very surprised about something, looking at the activity of any person, then you use this phrase, no wonder. Next is, by the way. Yeah, this is also a very nice phrase. When we use it, we use it to add something to already, you know, coming, going or running conversation in English. I'll give an example. Suppose you have gone to any apartment, a new apartment, you're planning to buy that apartment, and the person or the dealer or the person who is showing you the apartment is explaining so nice things about the view, the rooms, the structure, you know, the decor, and you suddenly asked, you're also involved and engaged in that communication, you suddenly asked, by the way, is there any storeroom in this apartment? So you have added one more thing in the running conversation with an addition, right? You said, by the way, is there any storeroom in this apartment? So you have added something by using this phrase. All right, I will give you suppose two people or two friends are having a conversation, and one friend is very much involved in the communication. Suddenly he's saying, by the way, I have a flight in the evening and I'm so much, you know, involved in this communication that I would have missed my flight. So goodbye. So it means that using this phrase, you are adding something additional in the running communication. Next is, how dare you? How dare you? My expressions are not matching with this, you know, phrase, because this phrase doesn't carry a smile on your face. Yes. Actually, this phrase carries lots of anger. When you're very much angry, then you use this phrase. So, how do you say this? How dare you push me back? You're standing in the queue, you know. Nowadays, queues for a lot of things, especially when you go in the sale time after any shopping outlet. So you'll see lots of ladies are there in the queue, definitely. So sometimes there's a quarrel going on. They're the not ladies, they're the gents also, whoever or she, he or she is. So somebody is pushing from back and another one who got the hits is saying, how dare you pushed me, right? Or suppose, one more very nice thing. A lot of girls who are little, you know, chubby, they're really cute, but lots of guys or girls just tease him by saying fat. So she can say, how dare you call me fat? Definitely it will bring angriness in you if you're being called fat. So how dare you call me fat? Next is, why not? All right. So we use this phrase to make a suggestion. Right, when we need to suggest someone, then we use this phrase. I'll give an example. A group of friends are actually planning for their group study. So, one more friend comes suddenly and say, I think I should also come at your place and should join you for the studies. So, one of them is saying, why not? You should actually come at our place. So, she is adding a suggestion. Another example, now there is going to come a lot of, you know, it's going to be a wedding season, weddings are in the cards, and all the girls out there, they're so crazy about their looks. So a group of the girls are planning for the dresses. So one of them is suggesting, why don't we buy ready-made dresses from the market, because weddings are on the head, and instead of going to the boutiques and getting stitched dresses, it will take a lot of time. So again, we have given a suggestion here by saying, why not? Next is, no matter what. No matter what means something regardless. Means come what may. No matter what you have to finish this project by the evening. Yeah, a boss is saying, I'm not concerned what is going to happen. I don't know, whatever you want to do is equal to no matter what, you have to complete this project by today evening. So, no matter what, you have to be fluent in your English, alright? And for that, you need to watch all the sessions of eVidyarthi very carefully. So do that. Alright, when you actually are emphasizing on something and you are not bothering about the whatever comes after that or before that, then you say with a lots of emphasis, no matter what, in a serious gesture. Don't ever means never, yeah. Don't ever go out in the scorching heat. Don't ever go for the late night parties. Don't ever lie me. Don't ever get lazy for your important works. So, don't ever is equal to never, but it's a phrase and you must be feeling that it's quite better and smart when you use it in the English communication. I bet if you watching the sessions very seriously and practicing after that, you're going to speak a very fluent English, right? So use this phrase when you are more than sure about something. I bet on you that he is gonna make it, right? He's gonna win the competition. I bet on this. So once you're very much sure about something, then we use this phrase, I bet. Alright, it may surprise you. But, I'll not give the meaning, I'll just give the example and you will understand the meaning. It may surprise you, but she refused my proposal. Yeah, I proposed her and she refused you. So, once you're sure for something to be happened, but that doesn't happen, or that has not happened, then the other person is saying, it may surprise you, but she has refused my proposal. It may surprise you, but we got tickets cancelled and we're not going for the vacation. Already we have planned for the vacation, but something happened and the friend of yours is informing you. It may surprise you, but we got the tickets cancelled and we are not going out for the vacation. It may surprise you, but what else? It may surprise you, but if you eat the sweet, you're not gonna fat because it's a sugar-free sweet, right? So, something you really sure that's gonna happen, you can say it may surprise you, but you can add something. What is not true? So, in this way, we have learned lots of smart phrases that is adding a meaning to your sentences to make it better and smarter. So, just read it carefully, learn it carefully and do use it. And what else you can do? You can subscribe if you really like. That's all for now. Bye.